is blowing right now, Russia, and they're tracking that most of the wind was heading southward. You can see in that diagram of the dispersal model. Russian media has speculated that the weapon being tested was the SSC-X-9 Skyfall, a nuclear-powered cruise missile. Now I wonder if that missile was fully loaded with this nuclear armament. Never let people live calmly in a clean environment. The previous test of this Russian cruise missile was armed with a super powerful nuclear warhead. So they are conducting these tests with their full nuclear armaments. So you can expect that also in your dispersal model. We can only speculate that Russians do these tests fully armed, so the fallout should be severe, packed with thousands of radioactive dollars from its onboard nuclear reactor, spewing death thousands of miles through the winds.
An investigation team meets near a military facility in Russia's far north. Moscow says they're investigating the explosion of a rocket engine at Nenoksa. The site is used for testing missiles for the Russian Navy. Russia's state nuclear company said staff members died in the blast, while U.S. analysts suggest it was likely a new nuclear-powered cruise missile that President Putin said Russia was producing in March last year. The United States formally withdrew from the 30-year-old Intermediate-Range Nuclear Forces Treaty with Russia last Friday. Russia's defense ministry said no dangerous substances were released in the explosion, although local authorities closed waters north of the site to shipping for a month. Greenpeace cited government data showing a radiation spike 20 times above normal in a city 30 kilometers from the test site.
The biggest threat is the release of radioactive substances on the inhabitants of a settlement located next to that military base. Nevertheless, for the inhabitants of Severodvinsk, a city, there could also be a danger depending on what kind of substances were released and whether they reached the town.
Residents took no chances. They bought medical iodine, known to block the absorption of radiation.
The events have shaken up the whole town. People started to panic. Within a matter of an hour, all the iodine and iodine-containing drugs were sold out.
4,000 kilometers away in eastern Siberia, another explosion at a military ammunition dump site. The government blamed it on lightning.
There was a big explosion. I saw a colored mushroom cloud. It was very bright. I was slammed by a door that sent me flying.
A fire triggered powerful explosions at the facility on Monday. It was home to more than 40,000 artillery shells. Thousands of residents were evacuated. Russians in both regions are now demanding transparency from authorities and the potential risks posed by the blasts.
The American military once attempted its own version of its nuclear power cruise missile, but dropped the idea as too dangerous, partly due to a key design flaw. The engine spat out radioactive exhaust, and the missile would spend that time spewing fallout wherever it flew. Russia has continued its research into this molten metal cooled reactor. It is rumored that the Status 6 nuclear powered torpedo that Putin discussed in his speech is powered by a lead bismuth reactor. And one of the most important issues is the radiological hazard associated with the activation of lead bismuth coolant upon neutron bombardment, and that is polonium-210, a toxic alpha emitter. Polonium is very dangerous because of its radioactivity, absorbed essentially in the kidney, spleen, and liver. And these organs, in the cases of polonium, suffer irreversible damage because of their complete absorption of the alpha particle energy. So they say the radioactivity of polonium is reduced by 6 orders of magnitude after about 8 years of cooling. But given level of radioactive toxicity would be maintained over 1 million years as a result of the decay of bismuth-210. That means that such a missile could leave a dangerous radioactive plume behind wherever it went on a long, winding flight path. A nuclear-propelled missile reactor would be capable of making many different types of radioactive isotopes. Now, some of the people responsible for causing the nuclear disaster are being promoted as heroes for contaminating their homeland. How can you call somebody a hero that just polluted your environment? No, that's not a hero. He's practically a traitor. Even President Trump weighed in on it and said, "The Skyfall explosion has people worried about the air around the facility and far beyond. Not good." It is noted that the recorded radiation had exceeded the normal radiation background by 20 times near the epicenter and wherever you see this light blues area.